Good afternoon, children. Today we are going to start with our new history chapter, lesson number 7, the administration of the Swaraj. In the last chapter, we have learned about the coronation of Shivaji Maharaj. After the coronation, Maharaj accomplished Dakshin Digvijay. It means the conquest of the south. The Swaraj expanded, comprising large areas of Nashik, Pune, Satara, Sangli, Kolhapur, Sindhudurg, Ratnagiri, Raigad and Thane districts of Maharashtra. It also included parts of Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu state. To ensure the smooth management of the affairs of the Swaraj and to ensure people's welfare, Shivaji Maharaj set up an efficient administration. In this chapter, we shall get some information about his administration. Children, in this chapter, we are going to learn about Ashtapradhan Mandal, the policy regarding agriculture, village economy of that period, trade and business, the military organization, intelligence department, forts, sea forts, navy, concern for the welfare of his subjects. Ashtapradhan Mandal, Council of Eight Ministers. At the time of his coronation, Shivaji Maharaj appointed a Council of Eight Ministers. The administration was divided into eight departments. A head was appointed for each department. This eight heads of department constitute the Ashtapradhan Mandal. Now, the designation were Pradhan, Amatya, Sachiv, Mantri, Senapati, Sumand, Nyayadish, Pandit Rao. Maharaj alone had the power to appoint a minister or to remove him from his position. The ministers were answerable only to Maharaj for the administration of their department. Shivaji Maharaj selected this minister on their merit and achievements. He did not give them jagirs, vatan or gift. Instead, he paid them salaries. Now let us see Ashtapradhan Mandal of Shivaji Maharaj. Name of the minister, their designation and the work. First, Moro Timbak Pingle. His designation was Pradhan and his work was running the administration and making arrangement for the conquered territories. Next is Ramchandra Nilkant Majumdar. Designation Amatya, work keeping the accounts of the state. Next is Annaji Dattu, designation Sachiv, work preparing royal edict, means order. Next is Dattaji Trimbak Waknis, designation Mantri. Work correspondence. Correspondence means letter written from one person to another or the activity of writing and receiving letters. Next is Ambir Rao Mohite, designation Senapati. Work organization of the army and protection of the kingdom. Ramchandra Trimbak Dabir, designation Sumant, work foreign relations. Next, Niraji Ravji, designation Nyadish, work dispensing justice. Next, Moreshwar Pandit Rao, designation Pandit Rao, work looking after religious matters.
The policy regarding agriculture. Agriculture was the main occupation in villages. Maharaj knew the importance of agriculture. That is why he paid attention to the welfare of farmers. Shivaji Maharaj knew the importance of the agriculture. That is why he encouraged peasant means poor farmer to bring uncultivated land under cultivation. And if the crop was lost due to the some problem, like for example excessive rain or drought, if there is no rain, that's known as drought, or if any enemy had destroyed the area of the villages, that time Maharaj cancelled the debt in the land revenue and other facility was given to the farmers. So he given this duty, responsibility to organize a land revenue system to his capable and experienced office bearer Annaji Datto. Maharaj had instructed his officer to provide peasant means farmers, with bullocks, ploughs and good seeds for sowing. Village economy of that period. Agriculture was the backbone of the rural area. As we have seen, agriculture was a main occupation of the rural area. So agriculture was the main source of income. And in the villages, many occupations also developed with the agriculture. Artisan in the villages produce goods and fulfill the needs of the local people. Now artisan in the villages, they make the goods and give to the local people. And in this way, the village was became a self-sufficient unit. Farmer gave a definite share from their produce to artisan. This share was called baluta. Now, when the artisan make a goods for the farmer used to give their share from their producer. For example, if they produce in their field like wheat, gram, groundnut, they used to give to the artisan. And this system was known as the baluta. This share was called as the baluta system. Trade and business. Maharaj knew that a kingdom does not prosper without an increase in trade. Merchants bring novel goods as also certain necessity into a kingdom. Good becomes available in plenty, trade prosper, adding to wealth. It was policy of the Shivaji Maharaj to protect the industries. An excellent example of this was a salt industry. He protected the salt industry in Konkan. At that time, what happened? The traders imported the salt from the Portuguese territory and sold it Swaraj. That affected the local trade in Konkan area. So Maharaj, what he decided to charge heavy tax on the salt imported into the Swaraj from the Portuguese territory. And Maharaj's view on merchant is seen in the Ajatapatra, where merchants are described as follows. Merchants are the ornaments of the kingdom and the glory of the king. Intelligence department. It was the job of the intelligence department to obtain information about the movements of the enemies and submit it to Maharaj. So that time it was necessary to protect the Swaraj from the enemy. So Shivaji Maharaj want each and every information time to time about the movements of the enemy. So that job was given to the intelligence department to get the information, and they have to submit this information to the Maharaj. And this intelligence service of Maharaj was very efficient. Bharaji Nayak was the head of this intelligence department. He was extremely skilled in his job. Now, for example, before the raid on Surat, he collected accurate and detailed information about the Surat and submitted to the Maharaj.
The military organization. There were two main divisions of the army of Shivaji Maharaj, infantry and cavalry. Infantry means soldiers who fought on foot. Cavalry means soldiers who fought on horseback. In the infantry, there were officers such as the Hawaldar, Jumledar, etc. The chief of the infantry was called Sarnobat. He was the highest officer in the infantry. In the cavalry, there were two types of cavalrymen, namely Shiledars and Bargirs. The Shiledar had his own horse and weapons. The Bargir was provided with the horse and weapons by the state. In the cavalry, bargees were more in number. The ranks of the cavalry officers were similar to those of the infantry officers. The highest officer in the cavalry was Sarnobat Netoji Palkar, Pratap Rao Gujar, Hambi Rao Mohite were some of the famous Sarnobat of the cavalry.
Intelligence Department. It was the job of the Intelligence Department to obtain information about the movements of the enemies and submit it to Maharaj. So that time it was necessary to protect the Swaraj from the enemy. So Shivaji Maharaj won each and every information time to time about the movements of the enemy. So that job was given to the Intelligence Department to get the information, and they have to submit this information to the Maharaj. And this intelligence service of Maharaj was very efficient. Bharaji Nayak was the head of this intelligence department. He was extremely skilled in his job. Now, for example, before the raid on Surat, he collected accurate and detailed information about the Surat and submitted to the Maharaj. Forts. Forts were of great importance in the medieval age. It was possible to stock the fort with food grains, war material, ammunition and military garrison. There were about 300 forts in the Swaraj. Now, during that time, forts were of great importance. Position of the fort made it possible to keep an eye on the surrounding area. For example, in the case of foreign invasion, it was possible to protect the people taking shelter in the fort, and also it was possible to stock the fort with the food grains, war material, ammunition. Ammunition means bullets, bomb, guns and so many things related to the war. And military garrison. Military garrison means soldiers can stay in that place in order to defend it. And there were 300, like this, there were 300 forts in the Swaraj. Shivaji Maharaj built hill forts like Pratapgarh, Pavangarh and Rajgarh. Shivaji Maharaj, there were so many fort built by Shivaji Maharaj, and some are them given in this lesson, like Pratapgarh, Pavangarh and Rajgarh. And for each and every fort, there were Kiledar, a Sabnis and a Karkhanis on every fort. Now, the work of the Karkhanis was to look after the storage of food grains and the maintenance of war material on the fort. Sea forts. One of the sea forts that he built was Sindhudurga at Malvan. It is an excellent sea fort. Now, Shivaji Maharaj knew the importance of sea forts. So, he built a sea fort was Sindhudurga at Malvan. It was an excellent sea fort. And to give the strength to the construction of the fort, 5 candies of lead was poured into the foundation. A sea fort called Padmadurga was built in front of Rajapuri in order to counter the Siddhi power. Now, Shivaji Maharaj built a fort named Padmadurga in front of the Rajapuri to counter the Siddhi power. About his fort, Maharaj has said in the letter that by construction Padmadurga, he has set another Rajapuri to overshadow the Rajapuri of the Siddhi. Navy. As the enemies started entering the India on the west coast of India, like for example the Portuguese of Goa, the Siddhi of Janjira and the British factors of Surat and Rajapur, created obstacle in the work of expanding Swaraj. So Maharaj realized that now it's the time to protect the west coast from this activity. So he raised the navy, and Maharaj realized that the one who has a navy can control the sea. There were 400 ships of various kind in his navy. They included battleship like the Gurab, Galbat and Pan. These were the name of the battleships. These ships were built in the creek of Kalyan, Bhiwandi, Vijayadurga and Malvan. To look after this navy, Shivaji Maharaj appointed the chief naval commander. They were Mainak Bhandari and Daulat Khan. Concern for the welfare of his subject. Subject means people. Maharaj's main objective was to make his subject independent. Shivaji Maharaj did not work only with the limited ambition of conquering enemy territories and establishing dominance. His main objective was to make his people independent. And he was aware that if his subjects were to really get the joy of freedom, it was necessary to have a disciplined administration, take comprehensive care of people's welfare and protect the conquered territories. Shivaji Maharaj was not merely a ruler, he was also a watchful administrator. Children, let's recall what we have learned today. Ashtapradhan Mandal, that means Council of Eight Ministers. Shivaji Maharaj appointed a Council of Eight Ministers. The administration was divided into eight departments. A head was appointed for each department. This eight heads of department constituted the Ashtapradhan Mandal. Next, the policy regarding agriculture. Agriculture was a main occupation in villages. Maharaj knew the importance of agriculture. That's why he paid attention to the welfare of the farmers. Village economy of that period. Farmers gave a definite share from their produce to the artisan. This share was called Baluta system. Trade and business. Maharaj knew that a kingdom does not prosper without the increase in trade. Merchants bring novel good as also a certain necessity into the kingdom. So trade prosper, adding to wealth. The view that Maharaj took of merchant is seen in Ajan Pantra, where merchants are described as follows. Merchants are the ornaments of the kingdom and the glory of the king. Next, the military organization. There were two main divisions of the army of Shivaji Maharaj, infantry and cavalry. In the infantry, there were officers such as Sahawaldar, Jumledar, etc. The chief of the infantry was called Sarnobat. In the cavalry, there were two types of cavalrymen, namely Shiledas and Bargis. The Shiledar had his own horse and weapons. The Bargi was provided with the horse and weapons by the state. Next, the intelligence department. It was necessary to protect the Swaraj from its enemy. For this, it was necessary to get precise and timely information about the movements of the enemy. It was the job of the intelligence department to obtain information about the movements of the enemies and submit it to the Maharaj. Forts. Forts were of great importance in the medieval age. Possession of a fort made it possible to keep an eye on the surrounding area. Sea forts. Maharaj knew the importance of sea forts too. One of the forts that he built was Sindhudurga at Malvan. It was an excellent sea fort. A sea fort called Padmadurga was built in front of Rajapuri in order to counter the Siddhi power. About this fort, Maharaj has said in a letter that by constructing Padmadurga, he has set up another Rajapuri to overshadow the Rajapuri of the Siddhi. Next, Navy. Enemies on the west coast of India, the Portuguese of Goa, the Siddhi of Janjira and the British factors of Surat and Rajapur created obstacles in the work of expanding the Swaraj. It was necessary to curb their activities and to protect the west coast. For this purpose, Maharaj raised a navy. Concern for the welfare of the people. Maharaj did not work only with the limited ambition of conquering enemy treaties and establishing dominance like other things. His main objective was to make his subject independent. Maharaj was not only merely a ruler, but also he was a watchful administrator who cared for his people's welfare.
Children,
In this lesson, we have learnt about that Shivaji Maharaj was not merely a ruler, he was also a watchful administrator who cared for the welfare of his people.
Thank you.